Right. We're going to determine if a given ordered pair is a solution to a system of two linear equations. All right, so a system basically means you have more than one equation, all right? And so any solution to a system of equations, it has to be a solution to each of the individual equations. So three things can happen if we have two linear equations. There may be no solutions at all. There might be one ordered pair solution, or you might have infinitely many solutions. And by infinitely many solutions, I don't mean any ordered pair is a solution, but there will be infinitely many solutions. So to determine if an ordered pair is a solution, what we need to do is find out if it's a solution of each equation. If the answer is yes, then it's a solution to the system. So let's try this example. Is 1, negative 2 a solution of this system? 3x minus y is 5, and 2x plus 5y equals negative 8. So let's just check. So first we're going to put it in for the 3x minus, let's try this one. So for 3x minus y equals 5, let's just see what happens if we put in 1 for x and negative 2 for y. So the question is, we're trying to find if this is true or not. 3 plus 2 equals 5. Yes, it's true. So we know that 1 negative 2 is a solution to that one. Let's try the other equation. 2x plus 5y equals negative 8. And we're going to put in 1 for x and negative 2 for y. And we'll see if this is true. So we have 2, this is plus negative 10 equals negative 8. And yes, that's also true. And so since both equations have 1 negative 2 as a solution, then 1 negative 2 is a solution to this system. So yes, the answer is yes. 1 negative 2 is a solution to the system. Okay. So in this case, that's what happened. Well, let's try a very similar problem. Let's ask if a different ordered pair is a solution. Okay. So what if we ask this question, is this ordered pair 5, 10 a solution of this system? So again, let's just try it. So first we'll try 3x minus y equals 5, and we're going to put in 5 for x, and we're going to put in 10 for y, and I have 15 minus 10 equals 5, and yes, that's true. So 5, 10 is a solution of 3x minus y equals 5. All right, let's try the other one. So we have 2x plus 5y equals negative 8. Let's put in 5 for x. And let's put in 10 for y. So I have 10 plus 50 equals negative 8. Absolutely not true. That's false. So it's not a solution. So our answer to this one would be no. 5, 10 is not a solution. To the system. It doesn't work. The answer is not true. Like a yes, unless it's a solution to both. Sometimes in the first equation you try, it's going to be false. You don't even have to check it in the second one. Already you know it's not going to be a solution to the system. But if it is true for the first one, you also have to verify it for the second one.